Hello and welcome to a new speed build. I hope you're all doing okay in these weird and strange times. I used my free time to build another build, and this time it's a home for a couple of vampires, or a vampire couple. It's not your typical dark and grungy and rotten vampire home, but it's actually quite colorful and quite cozy, I think. The shape's obviously very funky, as you can see here, so it has a lot of crooked sides and nooks and crannies, which made roofing a bit of a challenge, but I think I managed in the end. So of course I use a lot of octagonal roof pieces because I had all these cut-off edges, and then used this one gabled roof on the back part, but then I had this weird nook to cover. This is my solution for it. I'm actually not super happy, but it's in the back, so I ended up just keeping it. And then I put a lot of extra little roof pieces on the sides, as you'll see in a bit. That part that I'm doing right there is gonna be the entrance and where the door is. So the door's on the diagonal, which of course means that I need some stairs in a different direction. Then I was also very set on the roof color. Usually I try out a ton of different roof colors, but here I immediately sticked with the green one and think that works very well for this kind of vampire build. And then there you see that I put these little roof extras just for decoration. And then the black roof trims, of course, for vampires. And I was very unhappy though that you could see the white underneath bits of the roof, like where it hangs over. It's white on the bottom, and I hate that. I wish we could color that too. I wish we could color the ceilings in general. So I fiddled with that to make it like less visible, but it ended up just deleting those and pushing them all the way in, so there's no white on my beautiful dark green roof. And then this is, as I said, the entrance area where I'm gonna add stairs. But first, I think doors and windows. So I used these doors and windows from base game that came with an update, I think. I think they work very well for vampires. Of course, I use the vampire pack for this. So this is all base game except for the vampire pack. But for the windows, I actually sticked with base game. I didn't use the vampire windows because they are like very old castle, Victorian age style. And as I said, my house is not quite your typical vampire house. I did use these vampire roof decoration pieces though, these little pokey things. Size them down though, because they're quite big. And then some more little decorative roofs on the tower. So yeah, so I was quite sure from the start that I wanted this house to have a tower and a second level, although I end up just putting like skill building in the tower room, so all your necessities are on the ground floor, which I think makes it also easier for playing if you don't have to switch back and forth between the two levels. And then this piece that I'm building there is gonna hold some bushes and plants. This house also has a lot of plants on the inside and on the outside, so definitely plant-loving vampires. And of course, I had to build a trellis because it wouldn't be a house of mine if it didn't have a trellis. So that's what I'm doing right here. A bit difficult though with going over the corner. And then I started putting some bushes in there, so I deleted the foundation and used this as a bit of a fence, and then put the bushes in there. I cut out a lot of the landscaping in this video because it's already fairly long and there was a lot of landscaping, which was also often very repetitive. Of course, I also used these thorny thingies from the vampire pack and the ivy, though I'm not super happy with the vampire plants, especially like these thorny pieces. I think a lot of them look very artificial. So, I don't know. The ivory is nice, but I don't understand why it's shaped in this like a square. That's not a very natural shape. If you put that on a wall, you have like one patch of ivory, and I wish that was more round. But yeah, so I used these thorns on the floor, but not any of the dead bushes, because I wanted this to actually be quite lush. So that's why there is an excessive amount of green around the house. And then a little path, and then this fabulous tree. I just love that. I would use that all the time if I wasn't doing so many base game and limited pack builds, because this, of course, is also a vampire pack tree. But then I went to the debug menu and grabbed a bunch of trees from there, and there are some really nice crooked trees there that I think are base game, like the one on the right. I love that, and also the set of four little trees, and then put a small one on the front. So there's this forest patch in the back, and then there's going to be more flowers in the front, and later actually also a pond. But first, I think we're going to move to the inside shortly. Just these few little windows to make the roof even more crooked, and then there we go with the inside. Of course, I first needed the stairs to go up to the tower room. They take up half of the floor in the tower, unfortunately, but that couldn't be helped. And then that was my first attempt at the floor plan. I wanted to section off the bedroom in the back there, and you're gonna see me put the bed there in a minute there, because I thought that's nice and cozy, but turned out the Sims couldn't get there because of the stairs. So I deleted everything again and put the bed somewhere else. It's a bit crammed there next to the window, but well, maybe it stood somewhere else at some point. And then the bathroom stayed in the same place where it was, though, but I did not put the wall in the middle again. Instead, I put a basement, because, you know, they're vampires. They need a place to put their coffins, so that's going to be down there. But then that small nook is going to be the bathroom, and then kitchen in the front. I have to admit, I haven't actually played with vampires yet, so I'm not quite sure if they can or need to eat regular food. I put a kitchen anyway, because I really like the green kitchen and I thought it looked nice, and maybe you want to use this house without actually playing vampires, so I thought it's a good idea to have a proper kitchen. And then I built these shelves using these poles from Vampires in the Debug menu. I think they're for fences actually, but I sized them down and raised them up and made these shelving units out of them, which I think turned out quite nice. And then of course curtains on the windows to prevent all that sunlight from getting in. So I made sure, I think, that all of the windows in the house have curtains. I also don't know if that actually affects your vampires in The Sims. It's a bit embarrassing that I haven't actually played with vampires yet, and still I'm building a vampire's house. But I used my imagination. And then of course I used a ton of these jars that I use all the time in all my whimsical magical builds, because they just look like straight from some sort of fairy tale. And then I also used this book on a stand, but hid it in the counter to have like a little, maybe a cookbook or something, sitting on the counter, which I think looks quite nice. And then also a coffee pot if the vampires drink coffee. Well, I don't know. Well, I guess you can put something else in there too. And then for the bathroom, I again used all the stuff from the vampire's pack, like the vampire's shower, toilet, and sink. Just wasn't sure which color I would go for, but I ended up just using some gray and black, and curtains again, of course. And then also this flooring, which is also from vampires, which is really cool, and I love all the swatches of it. Yeah, and then candles and this sun. And some more candles on the floor next to the plant. I'm not sure if that's safe, but I wanted to give it at least like some mystical look. And of course you'll notice that there's no mirror above the sink, but there is a toothbrush because the little vampires have to brush their little teeth, and a little rug. And then with the floor, I again picked something from vampires, and actually the floor is a lot. Like the patterns, it's a mix, but I kind of liked it, although I wasn't sure if it's not too much, especially with the wallpaper that I'm gonna add soon. But well, yeah, I just wanted this to really be vampire-y, so I really wanted the wallpaper with the bats. But at least I decided that I wouldn't have it on all the walls, so I started with orange in that sleeping corner, although I changed that to, I think, just wood later. And then this little thing that I'm building there is just to hold some more plants. Because, as I said, these vampires are really plant-loving, so I wanted to give them some, like a lot of room for gardening on the inside too, and then put some curtains on those windows, because I said that's very important. And then I also put these flowers that actually go on the outside of houses. I put those on the inside. I thought that looked quite cool. And in the corner, then there's a little nightstand that's just regular. Again, so I don't know if the vampires have to sleep in coffins. There are coffins in the basement, but I did put a regular bed too, just in case. And also, maybe you don't want to show everyone that you're a vampire. If you're entertaining guests here, they'll see that you do have a regular bed. And I put that weird bird head on the windowsill under in those two windows. And then use those blue carpets. As I said, I wanted this to be really colorful, so I used red on the bed and on the curtains, and then dark blue for the rugs. And the green, I think I ended up with green on the couch. So just all the colors in there, and then yellow on the floor, of course. So there's a couch and that cool chair, which is also from the Vampire's Pack, and the chaise longue, and then that trunk as a stand for a TV. So you see, the interior is like all kind of old-fashioned. So my idea was that these vampires have lived in this house for a very long time, but they're not totally ignoring the changes in the world. So they do have a TV, and they do actually also have a laptop. So these are the modern touches that they invited in their old, crooked vampire home. And then, of course, they also have a lot of books. Originally, I wanted to use the bookshelf that's a door too, to have like a secret doorway to the basement, but I didn't have room to section off the stairs to the basement completely. So it's just a regular bookshelf, unfortunately. But I put some more books on the top. And then another one of those shelves that I did in the same way, like the ones in the kitchen, to give it more of a uniform look. Then there's also a violin. Actually, there's a lot of skill building in this house. You'll see, I put skill building everywhere. So, I mean, that makes sense, right? You spend eternity learning and doing things. And yeah, so there's another nightstand, this time with a blue lamp. Again, I wanted to bring in a lot of colors and also have it a little bit mixed and matched, because I imagined they have collected their belongings over a long time. And use that tree wall hanging thing that I think is so pretty. I think I used it again or bigger somewhere else. And then another one of those blue rugs. And then originally I put this punching bag there. You know, I have to keep fit as a vampire. But then I realized that I don't have a dining table yet, and I wanted a dining table, so I had to move that. That is what goes up into the tower room later. So if you do some punching, you can do that up there now. But yeah, also remember that I forgot the trash can, and then remember that I didn't have curtains on those windows yet, which, as I said, are very important. And then here you see, I realize I don't have a dining table. And then I also built this extra wall with the window, but I'm gonna delete that. That's why I cut out when I built it, because with the dining table, there wasn't enough room. But there was room for some more of these jars. And then, yeah, I did this thing instead with a decorative piece between the columns. Yeah, for the basement, I started with a lot of wood, wood on the wall, wood on the floor, and then those two coffins in different shades, though. But I decided to change the walls to this more brick thing to give it more of a basement look. And I avoided using these vampire pictures upstairs because I just found them too cliche. But down here, this is really more of a cliche vampire room. So I said the house isn't, but down here I went all in with the cobwebs and the scratches and cracks, and also put the statue, eerily standing in the corner, and then put ivy down here. And I did put a mirror here with the curtain hanging over it. You get to decide what that means. And then deleted all the lights and just had some candles. So yeah, quite creepy down there. And here you see the tower room. As I said, the stairs take up most of the floor space, unfortunately, but I managed to squeeze in a painting station and some shelves with some painting stuff involving also this chicken thing. I don't quite know why. But yeah, and some candles and plants, and some pictures that I imagine have been painted there. And then again, using these more traditional vampire paintings, and then the punching bag on the other side. And also a collection of aquariums. Aquaria? What's the plural of aquarium? I don't know. So, fish. There's fish there, too. Yeah, I think that's basically it for the inside. So I returned to the outside, and since the inside is so colorful and has so much like blue and pink and green stuff, I decided I want some more colorful flowers on the outside. So I went ahead and actually added a lot to the exterior. Cut out most of that though, because it, as I said, the video was already fairly long. That's also why I cut out how I made this lake. I think I've shown that in more detail in other videos. So I used a swimming pool, made a lake on the side, and you can actually swim in that. And then also put some planters for some more skill building. Found that weird twisted tree and these roots and combined both together over the lake. I think that looks quite cool. And then I went ahead and added some lights on the outside, and I think that's basically it.